Queen Charlotte is it's an origin story for Bridgerton. So if you've loved Bridgerton, you'll find out about the young Queen Charlotte, the young Lady Danbury, the young Violet Bridgerton, and you'll find out how those women got to be the women that we see in the regular show, what happened to them. Shonda has written every word of this. It's fantastic. It's really gripping, and the young kids who play the younger versions of us, we're in it as well, but there's a lot of the younger versions of us. Young people. the kids are fantastic.
Oh, let's have a look.
The king. No one will speak of him. No one. He is clearly a beast or a troll.
Understood.
You know, if I grab there, yes, perhaps you could assist me by lifting me up there?
One question. You do not like beasts or trolls? What he looks like matters?
I do not care what he looks like. What I do not like is not knowing. Now, here. Just take hold here. With a lift, I believe I can make it over the garden wall.
You want me to lift you over the wall so you may escape?
That is what I said, yes.
People will notice you are missing, will they not?
I shall worry about that later. Now, if you please, I just need a little help. Come, make haste.
I have absolutely no intention of helping you.
I am a lady in distress. You refuse to help a lady in distress?
I refuse when that lady in distress is trying to go over a wall so that she does not have to marry me.
So India Armatafio as Charlotte and Corey Mulcrest as King George III, and she doesn't want to marry the king, basically.
She doesn't want to marry the king.
That's it. So she's going to climb over the garden wall.
She's going to escape over the garden wall. And therein begins the metaphor for their whole relationship. It's beautiful. Corey and India are banging. That's all I can tell you, in a tick well done way.
I know we're just doing we're just fanboying on you here, right? But we want to just also mention that Adjoa is playing Richard III.
Mm-hmm. Playing. I'm directing it and playing.
And I know, but so this, can I just remind us all of the most famous Richard III performance? Here we go, Laurence Olivier.
Now is the winter of our discontent, made glorious summer by this sun of York. And all the clouds that lowered upon our house in the deep bosom of the ocean, buried. Now are our brows bound with victorious wreaths, our bruised arms hung up for monuments, our stern alarums changed to merry meetings.
He ruined it, didn't he?
Listen, don't knock Larry. You can't knock Larry.
It's back in the day, isn't it? That's how you did it.
Yes, I mean, there's always been different styles of Shakespearean acting. It was completely transformed by a guy called Ira Aldrich, who was somebody who was enslaved and in America and got here and got to be this superstar. He's the first guy to play Othello in 1824, anniversary in 2 years' time. So the styles change all the time. So mine might be slightly different.
I think it might.
Slightly different hairstyle.
What do you think, Chris, of that, seeing that Laurence Olivier?
It's quite clipped, wasn't it? Will you be the first ever woman to play Richard III on stage?
I don't know, because I'm just... Since I was a kid, I've loved Richard III, because just that sense of somebody being othered for what they appear like physically, and then negative connotations laid on them. Because
and he had, I mean, of course, back in the day, it was so literal, so they would have given him the hunchback.
Yeah.
You won't have that?
I won't have that, because what I want to talk about is what I call body pathologizing, where you go, that person doesn't look like us, they don't, so they're not our sort of people. So actually, they must be bad people. So I'm really interested in that. And the language works brilliantly. So I'm playing Richard III in an all-white cast.
All right, okay.
So you'll kind of get the difference.
Yeah.
And I've got a lovely actor called Joe Kloska, who, talking of The Crown, played Porchy in The Crown.
Oh, yes.
So he's going to come and play Buckingham. He's my pal. So it'll be a good...
A lot of people think of Richard III as a very nasty king.
Yeah.
And we then thought that maybe the hunchback, if I can use that old-fashioned phrase, was invented because people saw him as nasty. Then they find him underneath the car park in Leicester.
Unbelievable.
And bless him, he has got a severe scoliosis of the spine.
That's true, but as I thought when I was quite small, who was Shakespeare writing for? Elizabeth I. Who's Elizabeth I's grandfather, Henry VII? Who deposed Richard III? Her grandfather. So, you know, you're not going to...
True.
You know.
And we've got to also mention, just while we're on history of acting, which we love whenever Andrew's here, is that when Laurence Olivier did that, it was then spoofed, right, by Peter Sellers, who did this instead. Have a look.
It has been a hard day's night. Yeah. been working like a dog. It's been a hard day's night. I should be sleeping like a log. But when I get home to you, I find the things that you do will make me feel all right.
So, there we go. I don't know. What do you make of that?
Well, I love it. And also, it's the Beatles song, Hard Day's Night.
Of course.
And we open at Liverpool Playhouse. So, brilliant. Perfect segue. Thank you very much.
Love it.